most famous physical therapist on the internet.
Hi, I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
And together we are the most famous physical therapists on the internet, Brad.
In our opinion, of course,
Bob. It's always our opinion. Today we're going to talk about, Brad, how to use an inversion table safely.
Right. Now, inversion tables are typically used for low back, mid back pain management, or to get rid of it. There may be some
spine,
right, of the spine. Yep, there may be some controversy in that. I don't want to talk about that. What I do want to talk about, if you have one or you want to buy one and you want to know how to use it safely, and this actually is, in my opinion, because I've had one for 2 years.
So you're a good person to comment,
right? And I watched the video and read how they instructed to use it, and in general, I think I disagree. Not totally, but I want to go through it in general here.
This is our opinion.
Right.
And first off, we probably should talk about the people that absolutely probably shouldn't use it at all. Right,
right. Brad? Exactly.
Let's first, someone who has retinal detachments or glaucoma, because you're going to have increased pressure on your eyes when you're being inverted.
Exactly, exactly.
So,
pressure on the inner ear.
Yeah, if you have inner ear problems.
Yeah,
this would not be a good thing to do.
Blood pressure conditions.
If you have increased blood pressure or have a heart condition, I'd be reluctant to, because your blood pressure is going to increase when you're in that position.
Right, things.
So you could pull a muscle when you're in that position, and it does sometimes cause headaches.
Right, and I actually, when I first used mine initially, I tested it at the store because they had one set up, and this is what I would do if you're going to buy one: is go in the store, have one that's set up, and use it and invert and see if you have some results as far as decreased pain.
Or, right, or does it make things worse in some way?
Exactly. So when you invert, you should feel some immediate relief. And that's my opinion. If you do not, I don't think it's for you.
Right.
Now, the big question I want to jump back a little bit is, if you look at an inversion table, obviously, we don't have one here, but I think this will get the idea across.
So flat right there.
Here's the main frame. I've got three scenarios where you start, and then a partial inversion, and then a full inversion. So you have to adjust it properly so that when you lay down on the table, you should be able to balance it easily. And this is really neat. They're built well. The one I had, there's a lot of different manufacturers, but you get in a horizontal position so you balance well. And then to invert on the one I had, you would just lift your arms up and you would slowly go back. And it worked really nice. And you could go to a full inversion. Now I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, what if the device for the ankle holding you upside down fails and you fall down on your head and you break your neck? I'm thinking this is not healthy. So I didn't even go there. And I still think that this is not necessary at all. What I did with mine is, there was an adjustment on mine. I went to 60 to 70 degrees. There was a strap that could stop you there, and you would not go any further.
Okay.
And I found
you could set it for that.
Yep. And I found I had plenty of traction, because that's all this does to your back. It's a form of traction.
Sure.
It pulls your back apart, can help the disc and the muscles relax.
Using your body weight.
Exactly.
Right.
Yep. And so that's where I would set mine. I would not, I'd recommend not going more than 60 to 70 degrees. You will feel the effects. Now, the next big warning I'm going to have to say is, when you get on one of these and you invert, start out at 15 to 30 seconds and then go back to the horizontal position and see how your body reacts.
Okay, so you may be surprised if you go longer.
Right.
What may happen?
You might feel nauseous. You might feel like you had a headache. I inverted and I stayed there for about 3 minutes because I timed myself, because I test this out. It felt good. My back immediately felt better. I thought, this is good. I'm going to hang there for a while and really fix my back quick. Well, I got up from there. My back still felt better, but I had a headache, and it lasted all that night into bed.
Wow.
You know, so I went too much too fast. So start out at 15 to 30 seconds. Come up. If you feel normal, you can go back down, but I would not go more than that three or four times in a row the first time you use it.
So were you able to build up to longer times then?
Oh, yeah. Eventually, I would go no more than 2 minutes.
So
because my head would feel like there's too much pressure.
But you were able to go up to 2 minutes eventually.
Yeah, and it felt fine. And I know people that go longer than that, because I've talked to a number of patients that use these, and they do go longer. I just had a patient. She says she totally inverts. I still don't think that's necessary or really.
Sure.
It may be in certain circumstances, but I'm going to get
it's
that.
It's the risk reward.
Yeah.
The risk is too high.
I'm
for
thinking
the reward.
You don't need to get. Right. I think you get the same results with this as with maybe not, but that's my opinion, of course.
Yeah.
So, anyways, yeah, and I would do that. I'd hang for 2 to 3 minutes. My back would feel better. I would get off of it, and my back continued to feel better when I went upright and weight bearing.
Okay.
And you want to go all the way through that process. You could go, maybe it feels better when you're inverted, but when you get up and stand up, what if it starts feeling bad and you get a bad reaction to it?
Right.
Obviously, you're not going to buy one then. That's why I think testing it in a store is a good
idea. Absolutely. Good
idea. I used mine for 2 years, and eventually the effects it wasn't helping anymore.
Okay.
So I sold it.
Sure.
So I really
These are good tips, Brad, from someone who actually used it.
Yeah. And I hope that if you want to buy one, go ahead. They're usually around $100 to $200. You get what you pay for. Mine was over $200, but it was built well, and I really liked it.
Okay.
And you know how I feel about that, Bob.
Yeah. I hear it again and again about it. All right. Thanks for watching.